Hi, I am Manmad Krishna. You are watching Manmad Krishna Food Tech Channel. Now today we are going to learn about food safety HACCP definitions part 2. In our part 1 we have discussed some food safety HACCP definitions like critical control points, hazard analysis, hazards, etc. Now this part 2 we will discuss about what is corrections and corrective actions, preventive actions, monitoring, verification procedures and validation. So let us start the video. What is corrections and corrective actions? Corrections, an actions, immediate actions to correct the conditions or practices related to cleanliness and prevention of cross contamination and prevention of allergen cross contact must be taken in a timely manner in a short period of time is called corrections. For example, if in a cleaned equipment, if we found any food particles, then immediately we have to clean the food particle in a cleaned equipment. That is the corrections. And another example also, in a sanitizer concentration for dipping the equipments which are not properly sanitized, then immediately you have to re-dip the equipments or pans, utensils, and trays, freezing trays. That is the another second example of corrections. Corrections is the immediate action during the production of the food. Then corrective action. What is corrective action? Yes, it's very simple. It's not taken in a timely manner. If unsanitary conditions exist for an extended period of time, we must take the corrective actions. Whenever deviation occurs from a critical limit, we have to take the corrective actions. So whenever there is a deviation or failure to meet the critical limits, then corrective action we have to take. So that is the corrective action. Then what is preventive action? Preventive action is nothing but to prevent the reoccurrence of the incident in future is called the preventive actions. I will give you one good example to memorize these three differentiations. What is corrections and what is corrective actions and preventive actions? For example, Ramu and Somu are good friends. One day Ramu went to outside to buy some groceries, but the rain has drenched him. So Ramu, and next day Ramu was suffered with ill, fever, immediately has taken paracetamol. Then he recovered from the fever. So the paracetamol he has taken for the immediate, that is called corrections. And next time whenever Ramu wishes to go outside, he always carrying the umbrella to protect him from the rain. That is called corrective action. So Somu was observing the incidents of Ramu. So whenever Somu, since that day onwards, whenever Somu is going outside, he always carrying umbrella. That is called preventive action. But Somu never affected with fever. He never drenched by the rain, but he observed the conditions of the Ramu. So this is the preventive action, that is the corrective action. He has taken the paracetamol for immediate relief, that is called the corrections, and he has taken the umbrella to avoid from the rainy conditions, to avoid him from the drenching. That is also corrective action. Then the observing his friend the conditions of the Ramu, why you are suffered, you taken the preventive actions. So this is the good examples of this thing. Now the next definition, monitoring. What is monitoring? Monitoring is nothing but to conduct a planned sequence of observation or measurements to assess whether control measures are operating as intended. Yes, we have to observe and measure to assess the control measures are operating, our control measures are complying as per the intended purpose. So that is called the monitoring. This verification, the definition of the verification. The verification is nothing but the application of methods or procedures, tests, other evaluations in addition to the routine monitoring. Verification is the application of methods, procedures, tests, and other evaluations in addition to the routine monitoring to determine whether a control measure has been operating as intended to food safety plan or not. We have to verify the CCP mechanisms, the HACCP systems, the procedures, the methods and the tests and other evaluations. Besides doing routine monitoring, we have to observe that. So this is called the verification. Verification of critical limits, verification of CCP records, verification of HACCP system, like that. And what is meant by validation? Yes, validation is nothing but validation is an obtaining and evaluating scientific and technical data that a control measures or a food safety plan is capable of effectively controlling the identified hazard. That is called validation. Yes, validation is before start of the operation we have to do the validation, and verification is after start of the operations. Validation, the good example is cooking mechanism, cooking step, cooker. We are always validating based on a scientific or technical evidence by US FDA, D value, lethality rate. So based on US FDA D value, so they have validated the lethality rate of the pathogenic bacteria like Listeria, monocytogenes and Salmonella. So based on that, we have to validate. So in our country, India, CFT is validating the cookers. Yes, because based on what? They are obtaining the data and they are evaluating the scientific and technical evidence that a control measures or a food safety plan is capable of effectively controlling the identified food safety hazard. Here, cooking step is the food safety hazard. So based on the validation study, scientific data, so they have established if 72 degrees centigrade or plus or above, 60 seconds is a holding time. If plus 79 degrees centigrade or 80 degrees centigrade above, 6 seconds is the holding time. So there is a lethal study validation chart. That's all about the video, friends. And this video, especially I am doing the trainee technologists or the junior technologists who started their career as a technologist in food industry. Thank you. If you wanted to get the regular updates on my videos whenever I am uploading in my channel, please click the bell icon and subscribe to my channel for regular updates. Thank you and stay tuned.